What's going on, everybody? Nick Lahira here from SL Environmental. Thank you for joining us for this video. Now today I wanted to show you how to tell if you have asbestos in the air. Now the reason that most people do this is to verify that any type of abatement that has taken place prior to demolition or construction happening was done and the reoccupancy for people coming back, whether it's an apartment building or an office or even subcontractors, that the occupancy levels are acceptable and the clearance criteria has been met. And so I wanted to go through the actual mechanics of the air sampling. So what you've got is you've got your air sampling pump. This is a high volume pump, which is generally what you're going to want to make sure that your consultants use. By high volume, it basically means it goes up to 15 to 25 liters per minute. You have the Tigon tubing, which basically is the mechanism where the air is sucked in. And you've got the stand. Now this will generally be on the ground, and the air sample part, which is right here, will be sort of in the breathing zone. So that's one of the fundamental differences. The most important part of asbestos air sampling is what the cassette is going to be used. And you have two different choices. You've got the PCM cassette and you've got a TEM cassette. And I'll explain very briefly what the differences are. The PCM cassette, when you have it analyzed in the laboratory, they're looking for fibers or particles that fit within a certain size ratio and certain characteristics. Now, whether or not it's a dust particle or an asbestos particle, you can't tell in a PCM. So that's why it's a general exam. Now, the other exam is a TEM, which identifies asbestos fibers exactly. That's the only thing to look for. Now, the challenge is that for the TEM, they use electron microscope, transmission electron microscopy, which generally increases the cost from, let's say, $15 a sample to $100 a sample for a standard 24-hour turnaround. And that's generally across the board. And depending on the consultant, depending on the location, some of those charges may be higher for a TEM air sample. This is how it would work. You hook this up, and there's a rotometer, which is what this looks like. And the rotometer is used to tell and make sure the flow rate that you're using, let me actually just take a seat, that the flow rate in the pump, you know what it is when you start and what it is when you finish. And you hook up the pump like this. This is the cassette. So it kind of has this look to it. You want it down at a 45 degree angle. You obviously want to take the front off so it looks like this, okay? You turn it on, and let's say I've already checked with the rotometer, and I know what the flow rate is. I start their sample, that's what it sounds like. And you sample for however long you need to sample for, and then you turn it off. And then once you turn it off, you take a reading and to make sure you know the flow rate once it stops. Now, that's how it's collected. Now, what I'll do inside here is a white filter that is then looked at in the microscope. So when your samples go into the lab, they then look at it under a microscope and look for asbestos fibers or dust particles or any particles that fall within a certain size category. And that number is then used to determine the total fibers per cc or structures per millimeter squared, depending on the type of method. So for more information on the PCM and the TEM method, you can check out another video. For this purpose of this video, this is the best way to sample for asbestos, especially in a clearance criteria. So hope that helps. If you have any questions, feel free to send us a line on the email below, and thanks for watching.